sing of your glory. Every land has an offering of praise to give. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we thank you, Father. We give you honor, we give you adoration. We bless your holy name, Daddy, for another Wednesday that you have given unto us. We thank you, Father, because you make us to be a living being today. Father, Lord, accept our thanksgiving now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We thank you, Lord God, Father, for another episode of Deliver to Develop, a powerful program that we are using at this our generation to deliver your children all over the world. Thank you for the anointing, thank you for the fire, thank you for the grace, and thank you, Father, for the prayer point, and thank you, Father, for the way you are going to deliver us today in this particular program. Father, Lord, accept our thanksgiving now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord God, Father, we thank you, Lord God, for the few hours all over the world that are watching this particular program, that are being delivered from this, from different yoke, from different problem to this particular program, and that are giving useful comments, that are thanking you, Father, on this platform, and that are supporting this particular program all over the world. Lord God, Father, accept our thanksgiving now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father Lord, today is another merciful day, wellness day, in which you want to deliver us from the bondage of dream. Lord, I ask now for anointing that will break every bondage of dream upon your children all over the world now. I ask for the fire that will deliver them from the bondage of dream. And I ask for the authority that will deliver them from every bondage of dream all over the world now. Lord, release the anointing, release the fire, and release the authority now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Children of God, this is another merciful day, Wednesday, that the Lord has given to us. And I welcome you onto this platform again for your deliverance. This is a program that the Lord has given to us at this our generation to deliver us from different kind of captivity or different kind of bondage. Today, we are going to look at a particular theme, which is deliverance from bondage of dream. Deliverance from bondage of dream. Children of God, when we talk of bondage of dream, I want you to follow me to a particular portion of the Bible that gives us a kind of a dream, where we see dream and the interpretation of dream and what happened at the end. I want to read from Genesis chapter 40, verse 9 to 22. I am reading from Genesis chapter 40, verse 9 to 22. Maybe you are just joining us. This is the hour of deliver to develop. Follow me to the book of Genesis chapter 40, verse 9 to 22. I read, "And the chief butler told his dream to Joseph and said to him, 'In my dream, behold, a vine was before me.'" Verse 10 now. "And in the vine were three branches, and it was as though it budded, and a blossom shot forth, and the cluster thereof brought forth ripe grapes. And Pharaoh's cup was in my hand, and I took the grapes and pressed them into Pharaoh's cup, and I gave the cup into Pharaoh's hand. And Joseph said unto him, 'This is the interpretation of it. The three branches are 3 days. Yet within 3 days shall Pharaoh lift up thy head and restore thee into the palace, and thou shalt deliver Pharaoh's cup into his hand after the former manner where thou was his butler.'" Verse 14 now. "But think on me when it shall be well with thee, and show kindness, I pray thee, unto me, and make mention of me unto Pharaoh, and bring me out of this house. For indeed I was stoning away out of the land of the Hebrew, and here also I have done nothing that they should put me into the dungeon." When the chief baker saw that the interpretation was good, he said unto Joseph, "I also was in my dream, and behold, I had 3 white baskets on my head. And in the uppermost basket, there was of all manner of baked meat for Pharaoh, and bread did eat them out of the basket upon my head. Verse 18. And Joseph answered and said, this is the interpretation, therefore, the three baskets are the 3 days. Yet within 3 days shall Pharaoh lift up the head from of thee, and shall hang thee on a tree, and the bird shall eat the flesh from of thee. Verse 20. And it came to pass the third day, which was Pharaoh's birthday, that he made a feast unto all his servants, and he lifted up the head of the chief butler and of the chief baker among his servants. And he restored the chief butler unto his butlership again, and gave the cup unto Pharaoh's hand. But it hung the chief baker, as Joseph had interpreted to them. I pray for you. Every battery that may be affecting you presently now, even as you want to listen to this particular message, anointing of today shall destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Children of God, when we talk of dream is a universal gift given by God to every human being. It is not only when you are a pastor, prophet, minister of God that you must have dream. I call it a universal gift, because no matter what race you may come from, God has given that particular gift to everybody all over the world. And when we talk of dream is a gift that gives you revelation during your sleeping hour. It is a power of revelation during sleeping hour. That is when you are sleeping, the Lord wants to talk to you. You know, in the day, we encounter a lot of different activities, and the Lord may want to talk to us, but we may not be sensitive enough to receive what the Lord wants to say. And that is why when you relax, when you fall asleep, then God, in infinite mercy, will now begin to reveal things to you in your sleeping hour. And that is why I call it a universal gift. Children of God, when you talk of a dream, we are talking about gift that tells you what will happen in the present, future, or what has happened in the past. Dreams tell us three things. One, what want to happen, that is in the future, or what is happening presently now, or what has happened in the past. These are the three things that dream reveal to us as children of God. Therefore, you must pray that you should be able to have dream, because God wants to talk to you. Therefore, children of God, when we talk of dream as it's giving you revelation, it can give you revelation that is good. It can give you revelation that is not good. And when you have a revelation in your dream that is good, you need prayer. And when the revelation in your dream is not good, you still need prayer. Therefore, God has established this particular forum to deliver you from any kind of bondage of dream that you are passing through now. And I pray for you. Any kind of bondage of dream that you may be presently now, the anointing bestowed upon me today shall deliver you speedily today in Jesus' name. Children of God, we could see where I read for you now. We saw three people. We saw Joseph, and we saw two servants of Pharaoh. And these two servants, they had dream. One, the dream of butler, is a good dream. Why? The dream of the second servant is a bad dream. And we saw the way Joseph interpret the dream for each one of them. And you could see that the way Joseph interpreted the dream come to pass. I pray for you. Bad dream will never come to pass in your life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray for you today. Every good dream that you had before, the anointing that will make it to come to pass, God Almighty will release upon you today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Children of God, when you talk of bondage of dream, who are the people that are in the bondage of dream? One, when you normally you sleep, you have a dream that you cannot remember your dream. When you wake up, you are in bondage of dream. Two, when you had a dream and you cannot interpret the dream, either bad or good dream, you are in the bondage of dream. Three, when you can interpret the dream, but you don't have the anointing or the power to break the yoke of the dream, if it is bad dream, or to make it to pass, if it is good dream, then you are in the bondage of dream. Then, four, when you have dream, and this dream, you understand the interpretation, and it's a good dream. But up to now, the dream is yet to come to pass. Then you are in the bondage of dream. And that is why today the Lord has sent me to you in this particular platform, Deliver to Develop. And I pray wherever you may be, feel this particular program all over the world, the Lord will locate you with the fire you need. The Lord will locate you with anointing you need. The Lord will locate you with the authority you need. The Lord will locate you today with the angel you need that will make all that good dream that you had before to come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Children of God, when we talk of bondage of dream, it is one of the greatest bondage that is affecting believers all over the world today. And that is why today you will receive your deliverance in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Children of God, in which area can dream hold us in bondage? You may have a dream concerning your business. If you had a dream concerning your business and you don't get the interpretation correctly, that person may be in complete bondage. You may, Holy Ghost, Mary Masketeri Kasantari, I pray for you now. That dream that you had that is destroying your business gradually now, that dream be destroyed today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every evil dream that you had that is making you to make lust instead of profit in your business, oh, be destroyed today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Children of God, we can have bondage of dream in our marriage. You God may reveal things to you concerning your marriage, and when you don't understand the meaning, that person may be in perpetual bondage for life, and that will be the foundation of problem in that particular family until there's anointing to break that yoke of bondage. And that is why today is your day. I pray for you in your marriage now. If there is any bondage of dream, oh, be destroyed now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every bondage of dream that has been foundation of poverty, foundation of barrenness, foundation of sickness in your marriage, with the anointing bestowed upon me today, oh, be scattered now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Children of God, I want to give you this testimony concerning bondage of dream in marriage. 3 weeks before we are going into what they call lockdown, the church lockdown, but our heaven is opened. They may lock church down, but our heaven is open. Even your own heaven is open. When you pray to God, God will answer you wherever you are. After the Sunday service, we normally have grace for counseling for the new members. A young woman and a man, they came for counseling, and on that day, you know, the woman was the one that brought that young man into the church. That young lady has been attending our church, but is not our member. He knows the grace of God in the church. Then, when they came that day, this young lady said some things during the counseling hour. She said they were here because of the dream that she had, and the dream come to pass the way she had it. He said the dream is a bad dream, and the dream come to pass. And that is why two of them are here today, for them to be delivered, so that they will develop. They are yet to marry. The lady said, in her dream, she discovered that the young man beside her do not have manhood, that his manhood is not working at all. And she said when she received that dream, she first of all doesn't believe. She said a week after, she had a dream again. Children of God, when you are having dream upon dream, a single dream upon dream like that, God is revealing things to you. You have to be mindful of that particular dream. Then the lady said she now want to confirm the dream, whether what she received is true or not. He said she told the man that she's coming to visit him. But the man said, no, don't come to visit me. Don't come. Then the ladies began to look curiously to that particular answer. Then the lady said she now went to that part. She went to that man's house around 10 o'clock to verify. She said she wants to verify. You know, some people, they are very, very they are very, very curious when they want to when they want to get fat. She went there. Yet in the night, the man cannot do anything. She said, yes, I have confirmed my dream now. Then she said the man was running etta skata in the house. Then the man now said, his manhood is not working. So that is why they are here today. Children of God, I now ask the man, what happened? The man told me that she received an arrow 3 years ago in his dream. And that arrow has caused the problem. And he has been going to different places. No solution. And he knew that time is going. And I said, let him go and propose. Even though he doesn't, the manhood is not working, let him go and propose. Believe God will answer him. Children of God, and that is why they are here now. Children of God, you know, there is no woman that we like a man that is F9 in the house. A woman will like A1. We not, no woman will like F9 man. That man is, that is the way the lady said it. I said, what do you mean by F9? I laugh. He said he's an F9 man. He's not A1. Therefore, I said, let me pray. Let me pray. Because he said, you want me to pray so that the man can be delivered. I said, let me pray. The Lord told me he's going to deliver the man. That the man need to just bring water into Sunday service for 3 weeks. And he brought the water the first week, I prayed. The second week. Then by the third week, the man told me that his manhood is not working now. It's now working now. It's now working correctly. I asked, did you have any affair with the man, the woman? He said, no, he doesn't have affair. But the way his body is, that's the way he knew that his manhood is working. Children of God, our God is God of big problem, small solution, but mighty. The problem that he received in his dream was solved with the anointing, with the authority, and with the unction of God being released into the water for 3 days, for 3 weeks rather. I pray for you now. If there is any bondage of dream that is affecting you wherever you may be as you are listening to this particular program, by the reason of anointing that is coming down now, that yoke break now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Children of God, from what I've just told you now, many believers all over the world, they are having this marital problem, this bondage of the bondage of dream. The lady did not receive the dream. That is how she will enter into that particular marriage. And you will just hear that the marriage fell apart after 2-3 months. That is why you hear that a lot of marriage fall apart. Because they will not know what they are going to meet in the marriage until when they enter into the marriage. Similarly, in business, similarly, in joining, similarly, at school, similarly, in every area where human being is operating, we are having bondage of dream today. I want you to know one thing. That when you have a dream, that dream will be stored into your spirit man. And the dream will be waiting for the time to come to pass. And that is why today we are having the grace, we are having the power, we are having the anointing that will deliver everybody that may be in any form of bondage of dream. And we have some prayer points in which the Lord will use to set us at liberty today. children of God, when you talk of, when we talk of bondage of dream, it is a universal bondage. That is why it need what? It need a serious anointing to break. Because you are your dream. What you are passing through presently now comes through dream. God has revealed the dream to you. When you receive the dream, you may remember. You may not remember. But I know it comes through dream. Either bad or good, it comes through dream. The stage you have today happened through dream. What you are going to be tomorrow, God will reveal through dream. What has happened in the past in your family that you need deliverance upon, if you are a prayerful person, God will reveal it to you through dream. And this is the reason why we need to pray to be delivered from what we call bondage of dream. And I pray for all believers that is listening now, that is feeling this program at this particular hour. Oh, the fire that you need for deliverance shall be given to you today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Children of God, I have a lot of analysis in that area of bondage of dream. At times, people may want to put you into bondage by telling you a dream that they do not have for you. They can use dream to put you inside bondage, if to create fear into you. That's why the Bible said we should test our spirit. Children of God, you have to be able to test this our spirit when it comes to dream that people tell you that they have dream for you. A popular person, a popular chief in Akureland called me 3 days ago. He said, "Daddy, there is a particular dream that a young lady in that is staying with my mother had." And I said, "What is the dream?" He said, "In the dream, the lady says she died, and they could not even see the corpse, that the corpse was under the bed, that they were looking for him. And it was the wife now that discovered the corpse under the bed." And you know, no, when you hear death, you'll be fearful. This man was fearful. He need the interpretation of that particular dream. He need anointing that will break the yokes from that particular bondage is already in, according to the young lady. He said, "Daddy, pray. What is the mind of God concerning about a particular dream?" I said, "Give me some minutes and we'll call you back." Then, after some minutes, I pray. The Lord told me, the lady framed it, that it is not a revelation from God. The lady framed that particular dream. And it is a kind of a concerted effort from the mother of that man and the lady. Two of them, the mother wants to correct a particular habit in that particular in that man's life. And therefore, there is a kind of a conspiracy in order to use dream to make the person to be fearful, so that from there he will now desist from that particular habit. Children of God, that is not the way to correct any habit, because everybody believes that dream is very, very powerful. Don't use dream. Don't tell people dream that God will not reveal to you. If you are doing that, you are making them to be in bondage. And I told the man, I said, "You know me, I will tell you the reality. You are having a particular habit, and that particular habit is what they want to correct. and they don't know the way to correct it. That's why they use dream. And you too, you should go and deceive from that particular habit. You know what the man did? The man laughed. When she laughed, she said, I will go and amend my way. Children of God, people may put you in bondage or dream when they want to correct some bad habit. They may frame dream and say, this is what they receive for you. That is why Bible says we should test all spirit. When they are talking about dream, when they are giving you dream, you should be able to test all spirit behind the dream so that you will not go and be in bondage. Children of God, I want us to pray now. I want us to pray this particular 15 prayer point that we deliver you, that we liberate you, that we break the yoke of dream in your life. If we said we should continue to treat this particular program, we can use more than 10 years to treat this particular program, because dream is a universal gift. Dream is one of the way that God talks to us. Dream is what you have today. You cannot be greater than your dream. And that is the reason why it is a topic that you need to look at curiously and check inwardly, so that you need to get your deliverance for you to develop. Let us go into the prayer session. I know you have been waiting. Holy Ghost, Mary Masketeri Kasantari. That particular dream that you had that want to make your eyes to blind, I receive for you now. That dream will not come to pass. The arrow sent to you in that dream that may want to make your eyes to blind, that arrow now back to sender in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That arrow now catch fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Children of God, let us pray this prayer point. These are the prayer point that we need to pray with fire, with fire, with fire. Because when we talk of bondage, bondage cannot go with bread and butter prayer point. Bondage can never leave you with bread and butter prayer point. Bondage can never leave you when you are praying as if you are eating bread and butter. Bondage is a thing that might have been in your life for years. That is why you have to pray with us. See, that is why you have to pray as a person that determined that you want to get your freedom today, and you will get your freedom in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Children of God, let us pray now. Every storage of evil dream in my body be destroyed today in Jesus' name. Every storage of evil dream in my Oladire's body be destroyed now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every storage of evil dream in my body, every storage of satanic dream, every storage of dream of demotion, dream of sickness in my body be destroyed now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every storage of dream of sinning in my body, oh, be destroyed now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. All this satanic storage in my body, cast fire now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Children of God, storage is like a storer, whereby you store water at home. When you had dream, day by day, it is storing. And that is what the Lord is doing presently now. To remove every evil storer, to remove it from your body now. so that you will get your deliverance today, so that you will be developed now. And that is your portion now, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Children of God, prayer point number two. Assign demon that sleep and wake up with me every day. Cast fire today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, they normally oppress you in your sleeping hour. This is your prayer point. Assign demon that sleep and wake up with me every day. Cast fire now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That demon cannot go with bread and butter prayer point. You need to pray with your fire now, with the Holy Ghost now. Every assigned demon that wake up and sleep with me, that sleep with me, that wake up with me every day, that's giving me bad dream. Oh, catch fire now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Any assigned demon sleeping with your children and making them to bed wet. Oh, that demon be destroyed today in Jesus' name. A lot of children are bedwetting. It is because there is assigned demon that make them to bedwet. I'm praying for you now. All assigned demon that make you to bedwet, they sleep with you, they wake up with you every day. By the reason of anointing today, catch fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You are delivered. Oh, thank you, Father. Children of God, we are on prayer point number three. All witches' dream that causes monthly sickness for me, cast fire today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. There is always a monthly sickness. There is always a yearly sickness in your body. And what caused that sickness is when you normally have a particular dream. The Lord is using it for you now to tell you that today is end of that particular sickness. And I pray now, as you are praying along with me, as we agree together now. Oh, all which is dream that causes monthly sickness for me, catch fire today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It is only fire that can destroy, that can burn it, that can win it. And that is why you have to pray with fire of Holy Ghost wherever you are now. Oh, all which is dream that causes monthly sickness for me, catch fire to the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, if you normally sick weekly, monthly, you cannot be great. Sickness will never allow you to show your color. Sickness can never allow you to display your gift. Sickness can never allow you to be great in life. And that is why you have to deal with that particular sickness in your body. I pray for you now. Oh, you arrow of sickness. Oh, that you have been carrying, you have been managing the arrow for the past 2, 3, 4 years now. Oh, be scattered in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, you are delivered. Oh, go and develop in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That your gift will develop. That your talent will develop. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Prayer point number four. Every evil dream of setback and demotion in my body. Oh, out today. Oh, stand up wherever you are now. This is a prayer point that you need to pray with all your seed, with full determination. Oh, every dream of setback and demotion, out today. Oh, after the lockdown has gone, then you are going to back to your business. You must not go with setback. You must not go with demotion. That's why you have to pray that particular prayer point. Every dream of setback and demotion in my body, out today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, in my body, the dream of setback, the dream of demotion, the mythology of bodies, out today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I will go forward. I will go forward. I will receive my promotion, not demotion. Oh, pray. Pray. Call your name. Mention your name. Mention your name and pray with us and receive your deliverance. Go and develop in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for the grace. Thank you for the anointing. Thank you for the hinder that is working now. Number five, prayer point. Arrow of dream of stagnancy in my body, cast fire now.
Oh, I will not be stagnant. I will not be dumped in a place. I will not be dumped in the house. Oh, I will not be dumped anywhere. Don't be a dumping soul. Don't be a dumping person. Oh, don't allow yourself to be dumped here and there. You must move forward. Out of stagnancy that you receive in your dream. Out. Stand up and pray. You must not be stagnant. Your life will not be stagnant. Your brain must not be stagnant. Your business must not be stagnant. Your marriage must not be stagnant. This is the hour of deliverance to develop. Oh, the Lord is delivering everybody all over the world now. That is joining particular prayer point now. Ah, that arrow, catch fire. You are delivered today. Go and develop. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord God, Father, for what you are doing presently now. Evil anointing for familiar spirit dream, dry up today. Every evil anointing for familiar spirit dream, this is a prayer point that will make you to have money. Oh, you said you don't have money. Oh, pray the particular prayer point. You are carrying anointing of familiar spirit. Number 6 prayer point is powerful prayer point. Evil anointing, oh, for familiar spirit dream, dry up today. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, family prison that cage all my good dream, cast fire today. Family prison that cage all my good dream, cast fire today. Family prison that cage all my good dream, cast fire today. All family prison that cage all my good dream, cast fire now. That good dream must come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, family robe that tied me with sorrowful dream, break today. Every family robe that tied me with sorrowful dream, break now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every family robe that tied me with sorrowful dream, break today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, children of God, we are going to pray now. Evil command that they give to me to eat food in my dream. Oh, who is that commander? Be destroyed. Who is the one that is giving me evil command that I must eat food in my dream? Oh, that commander be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every evil commander that give me command to eat food in my dream, die now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, you are delivered. Go and develop. Oh, thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Then this is another prayer point. Evil command that make me to have sex in the dream. Oh, die now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every evil command that makes you to have sex, that normally makes you to have sex in your dream. Somebody is giving you that evil command. Who is that commander? Oh, be destroyed now. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Evil commander. Oh, that give me evil command. Oh, to access. Oh, in your dream. Oh, die now. Oh, that command. Be destroyed. Be destroyed. Be destroyed. Be destroyed. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, you are delivered to develop. Children of God, we have to pray this particular prayer point now. This is the prayer that will give you a turnaround. Oh, number 11. Anointing for successful dream, fall on me today. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Anointing for successive dream, fall on me today. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Success is in you. I could see success. You have had a lot of successful dream that must come to pass. You need anointing before it can come to pass. Oh, anointing for such a dream, fall on me today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Holy Ghost, fill me up for heavenly dream. You need heavenly dream, not this earthly dream, not kind of dream. Holy Ghost, fill me up today. Oh, for heavenly dream. I need heavenly dream every day of my life. Not this kind of dream, not this worldly dream, not evil dream. Lord, Holy Ghost, fill me up today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, we are number 13 now. Holy Ghost fire, fill me up for action in my dream. Oh, children of God, this is your prayer point. Oh, the way you show action. Oh, when you are praying, that is the way you will show action in your dream. When they want to attack you, that is why you don't need to pray as if you are tired. You pray with authority. Oh, that is where fill me up for action in my dream. You need action in your dream. There must be action in your dream, and you cannot show the action unless you receive Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. For I shall be empty of my dream. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. God has answered by fire. Answer me today in Jesus' name. You want God to answer you today? Today is a merciful day. Today is a day of blessing. Today is a day of success. Today is a day of new event. You need that particular prayer point. Oh, God has answered by fire. Answer me today. The Lord will answer you today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, and you will surely develop. The last prayer point for this particular deliver to develop of this particular Wednesday. Oh, power above evil dream, fill me up today. Oh, there is a power that is above evil dream. When evil dream come, power will swallow it up. They have had a lot. I've had a lot of evil dream, even concerning myself. Oh, and power of God has been swallowing them. When you have an evil dream, don't be fearful, children of God. God is telling you you need to pray. Power above evil dream. Oh, fill me up now. Power above evil dream. Fill me up today. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Power above all evil dream this year. Fill me up today. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name we pray, you are delivered from bondage of dream. Go and develop. Go and develop. Your marriage will develop. Your business will develop. Your talent will develop. Your gift will develop. Oh, everything around you will develop. Deliver to develop. Children of God, we thank God for the Holy Spirit. We thank God for the fire. We thank God for the unction given to us. We thank God for people that are already receiving their deliverance all over the world today. Lord, continue to use this prayer point. Even for people that will pray after the program. And let there be testimony. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Children of God, every Wednesday like this, at the time of 7:30 to 8:50. Meet us on this platform. This is from Christ Glory Prophetic Ministry International. And the theme of the program is Deliver to Develop. Receive your deliverance. Go and develop. Bye for now.